Hey man, welcome back. This is the Shredding Hippie Surf Show. And this here is the Shredding Hippie Thumper, your 70s surf guru, man. Here on the Shredding Hippie Surf Show, we talk about surfboards. We talk about surfing, and I'll throw in little bits of the history of surfing. I've been surfing for 40 years, and I got a lot of stories about the changes that have happened in surfboards over the years. And most importantly, we're here to talk about why the 80s sucked worse than disco. But today, we've got a surfboard to review, man. And that surfboard is the Lost Puddle Jumper. This guy right here. So, if you're at all into surfing, you have heard of this guy. What's great about Lost and Matt Biolas is that he's one of the few big time shapers now that is spending a lot of time shaping boards for guys like me. You know, man, I'm not 15 years old. I don't weigh 85 pounds. I've been surfing and I know how to surf, but I need volume for my big muscular frame and my gray hairs. They need volume to paddle and to float me and to catch waves and still be able to shred, you know? For me, I can't tell you, man, how many times I heard when, you know, the shredding hippie spent some time away from the water. I know, don't hold it against me. But when I got back into it, there was all this change going on with surfboards and people were telling me, oh yeah, you know, at your age, you're gonna have to ride a longboard or you're gonna have to ride a funboard. And I'm like, screw that. Thank the surfing gods for Lost because they make boards like this. So this board here is what is known as a groveler, which means that it's for small waves. And it's got this whole little thing. Now, I already reviewed the Channel Islands Average Joe. That is a groveler. This is not a groveler. It looks like a groveler. I know it looks almost, if you were to look at it, you can't tell the difference between this and the Lost bottom feeder. It's got almost identical looking features. But this thing does not surf like a groveler. I mean, as soon as I took off, it started acting like a high performance shortboard. In fact, you know, if I wanted something to act like a groveler, I would take that out any day. That's a groveler. That guy right there will catch waves this high and surf big waves. But that's for another review that we'll talk about at another time. This one is not a groveler. I would say that this is a smaller wave, high-performance shortboard. In fact, I would have no problem taking this out on shoulder-to-head high days. No problem. In fact, it'll probably do really well. I wouldn't take this out on ankle-slapping days. It's just too much of a high-performance board. So let's talk about why this board is so cool. And by the way, before we get any further into this, man, I got to share with you the Shredding Hippie surfboard scoring system, which starts on the low end is totally lame, and then on the high end is totally bitchin', man. So this board, totally bitchin', man. It just, I'll get into it, but I mean, there's just so many really cool things about it. But let's take a look at what this is. Now, the Shredding Hippie, in case there's anybody out there that wants to you know, give surfboards for him to review. The Shredding Hippie volume-wise needs between 45 and 46 liters, 47 on the outside, depending on what kind of board it is. But yeah, if any lower than that, I'm not too happy. Above that, and it's way too much. You know, the Shredding Hippie does not surf longboards, man. That's the closest I get to a longboard. But this one here is 6'2", 22, let's see, I can't read that. Let's turn this around. Okay, so the dimensions on this are 6'2", 22 and a half by 288, 46.37 cubic liters. Now, I'm going to tell you with this board, don't be afraid to go big on the volume. when I saw how much volume this had, I went, oh, that's pushing it. You know, 46 and what was it? 46 and a 46.37, almost 46 and a half liters. I thought, you know, that's getting a little too much. But I did not feel that at all. When I was out, in fact, it felt like it was around 45 liters. It absolutely did not feel like a lot when I was surfing it. It surfed, like I said, I felt like I was on a high-performance shortboard. Did not feel like I was on something that was supposed to be big and floaty. So, again, don't be afraid to go on the high end of the leaders with this, because that's what this is for. You know, this thing, man, is here for to catch waves, to help you paddle, help you have a good time in smaller surf that your high-performance shortboard wouldn't be able to function in very well. So, this is not a groveler, I would call this. It surfs like a hybrid shortboard. So let's find out why. As I said, this is almost exactly like the bottom feeder, but it surfs very differently than that, and we're going to take a look at why. So if you can see, maybe you can, maybe you can't, there is some concave in this board. So what they did is they did something that you're not supposed to do with small wave boards. Small wave boards, you're supposed to have flat bottom with V, which, by the way, works really well. So, but apparently he just decided, you know, maybe he smoked a little too much weed that day, man. But Matt Bielis decided to change that up a little bit, and he did the opposite. So he put concave in it, single concave running through it. It looks like there's double concave in here, I can see, and some V coming out the tail. And looks like he put some more rocker into the nose. Looks like there's some little more rocker in the nose. And there's some other stuff that happened that I don't understand, which, because the concave is there, it allows him to put, you know, more rocker in here and the less rocker to flat into this, and things I don't get, man. But all I know is that it works, man. And so that's the deal. So let me tell you about my experience of surfing. When I took this board out, it was probably, you know, it was a fairly small day, but it was actually kind of walled, and it was the tide was kind of low, so it was pitching, and you know, there were some barrels, man, and you know, so it gave me a real good opportunity the first time I took it out to test its limitations, because those are the worst conditions to try and surf in, when it's small and barreling and pitching and walled and closed out. It's like, oh man, every board hates that condition. This board did things that really surprised me. First off, I expected it to turn like a groveler. You know, like the Average Joe. Average Joe is a decent groveler. Don't get me wrong, it'll work. It'll take you into waves, and it's designed to be loose. It's real corky, so you can flip it around and, you know, do all kinds of stuff and feel like you're accomplishing something in the whitewash. I was expecting this to have that kind of a feel. I went into it going, okay, I've heard all great things about it, but man, it did not do that. It just, when I turned, it not only was loose, and it not only was responsive when I went to go turn it, but it was also, it felt really refined, like it was a refined high-performance short. It was like slicing through butter. It was a blast to turn, man. I could put in some nice carves in it. I could get it on rail. I did not feel like I was on a groveler. I already said that, man. I didn't feel like that at all. Yeah. So I'm rating this board as totally bitchin'. And it went above and beyond my expectations. You know, I've ridden it a few times, and I'm really actually wanting to take it out when there's a decent swell. You know, when it's shoulder to head high, and I want to see what this thing can do, because I felt very confident that I could take off on a wave with some meat on it, and you know, do some serious damage to the face of that wave, man. So anyway, that's the deal with that. All right, so we got some cool stuff coming up. So, hey man, subscribe and like, and you know, that's it for the shredding hippie this time. Dead to the Dead.